Okay guys, we're gonna try to put this overlay on and we're gonna do it dry. Saw this on YouTube and it actually worked pretty good. I've done them wet before. I've posted videos, but we're gonna do it dry. So this is KISS. So what we did is we lined the overlay up. So it's basically where it's gonna be on its final applied position. Do this in two parts. Put some tape here. Tape is holding it. So if I try to lift it to move it, it ain't moving. Okay, and then when it rests, it'll end up right where it needs to be for the jewels inserts to come through. Okay, so we're gonna do the two parts. I'm gonna do the hinge method. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut it, the backing off, and then apply it dry. We're gonna roll it just like you roll sod, if anybody's ever done. Okay, you don't really need much as far as equipment goes. You definitely need time and a steady hand and some nerves. This is a one-shot deal. If this doesn't go as it's supposed to, then the overlay is pretty well shot. So all I'm going to take right now, scissors, I have a glove. Look at that. And I also need a cloth. Okay, this is important. Anything that's on the play field here, anything, dust, lint, you name it, it's gonna show through the overlay once it's applied. So make sure this is nice and clean. I've already degreased it. I've already sealed the wood. So it's perfect, okay. Now, before I put my glove on, and the glove, you'll see why that's gonna come in handy in a couple of minutes, but all right, first thing we gotta do is take the backing off the overlay. This will probably take longer than it will to install the overlay, believe it or not. We're gonna start peeling the backing now. And guys, this does take some nerves of steel because these time and you'll be fine. Okay, so this is the backing. The overlay, the sticky part is up here. I'm gonna cut the backing off. Okay, you're gonna get rid of the backing. This stuff's slippery, believe it or not. Make sure it's nowhere near your work area. All right, here's where the glove comes in. You're asking, what are you doing with that mighty fine glove? Can't be that cold. Well, actually, it's not. So as I start to lay this down, just attach the tape. What I'm going to do with this glove is basically I got the ruler here. All right. Put the ruler on, and what the ruler is going to do, it's going to keep this thing stretched. And guys, make sure that it's on the ruler or something flat. It doesn't have to be a ruler, but it has to be something flat, stiff. I don't know if you can see it. I'm just resecuring it. Okay, here's where the glove comes in. So as I start to, I'm using this glove and I'm just basically rubbing it down. Just going over it. You'll see it a little better on the other side. There we go. As it goes down, I'm just gently making sure that it's adhering to the wood substrate without any air bubbles. And as you can see, this ruler trick here is helping keep it nice and taut. So as I apply, this is almost down. And again, I don't know if you can see, but this glove, rush approved, mind you, is giving me the ability to go over this. So it glides basically, I guess is what I'm trying to say. Anyway, okay, so this is down. Detach. I might just cut it off, to be honest with you. But let me get my X-Acto knife. You notice we don't have that much equipment. Basically a knife, a rag. Okay, done. All right, part two. So I just want to make sure this is down, no air bubbles, no bubbles, no troubles, okay? Yeah, that was corny, I know. Okay, whatever. All right, now we're gonna flip gloves. I'm gonna roll this part up. This part is a bit tricky as well because we gotta get the plastic part removed again, and basically it's rinse and repeat. By the way, this stuff sticks like grease lightning. It's unbelievable. I don't know what grease lightning is, but I heard that expression once. And there's other expressions, but they're a little risque to be talking in a public forum, so. All right. Backing, slowly but surely. And if your name is Shirley, I apologize. Okay, almost, all right. Now just hold it. I wanna hold it tight because I wanna get that ruler on here again. There's the ruler. All right, now the overlay here. Okay, here's where the tricky part is, where it separates. Because remember, okay, now I have to remove the tape because its job is done. I'm actually gonna take my glove. There ain't no station, I can tell you that. Okay. Just giving a little tug, because this is, okay, the game of this stuff is really slippery, guys, so get it like right out of your work area. To be honest with you, it's like the Continental Divide. If you don't know what that is, look it up. So basically, I gotta lift it out. If this ruler goes, I'm done. Anyway, I'm gonna start now. With the hand action. Okay. All right. Remember, air bubbles are no good. We have a way of dealing with them, but to be honest with you, if you don't get them in the first place, you're a rock star, so, okay. Just going over it. Okay, this part's gonna get a little tricky because I got a lot going on here. Right, it's kind of imperative that all the jewels line up. And more importantly, that we don't get any bubbles trapped, because bubbles, again, there is a way to get rid of them. It's not rocket surgery, but if you don't have them to begin with, then life is better, right? Okay, so I think we're doing pretty good, guys. By the way, it's center out. Don't start from this side and push in. It's always center, push out. Okay, and don't pull this thing too hard because you do run the chance of tearing. All right, okay. Almost. I'm gonna call that success. Okay. Hopefully, anyway, let's see what happens when we take this piece of tape off. Again, gently, guys, nothing, you don't do anything overly aggressive or quick. Okay. And we're gonna get our J roller. No. that way. Okay, basically just rolling this up. Did you hear that? Those were some bubbles. Bubbles mean troubles. But I'm good because they weren't on the graphic part. They were actually on the clip part. Okay, center out. It's not really that critical. When you do them wet, you definitely have to do center out, but dry, it's just making sure that this thing is stuck on, which it is. And if you notice, I'm not really going too aggressive on the parts that are white because I'm gonna cut the decal. I might show you that, but it's not really a heck of a lot of interest there. Okay, this came out perfect. Let me show you what's going down here. Everything lined up. All that white is going to get cut out. Everything here down is going to get cut out. That's kind of your view. And I'll show you the finished product, but yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. Again, I've done these dry. I've done them wet. There's definitely advantages to both. I think I'm becoming more partial to the dry method, to be honest with you, because wet, there is a ton of opportunities for bubbles and things of that nature. But anyhow, all done. Signing out.